This is actually one unit. That used to be a wall. That's a bedroom. And this was a living room. And then there's a wall going across here with a door opening into there. We take that out and we're going to make this into a great room, have a little kitchen area or a dining area. And then this is going to become second bedroom. And you go through this hallway right here. That's the third bedroom. This right here is a bathroom. This is a whole nother unit. Used to be blocked off right here, but we're gonna take area, make this into a closet for over there. And then we're gonna put a closet in the hallway right here. And then we'll have access to the back of the shower if we need to do maintenance. And this is the one that we're doing now. This is the bathroom. We had to add some wood. It was totally rotted out. We're gonna end up having to replace that, but this whole wall we'll end up having to rebuild. We'll put one window in and then we're gonna mount a window unit that'll heat and cool coming in. We'll replace that window, new electrical throughout, ceiling fans, these cool lights right here. Whoop, whoop, there it is. This is what Sundays is all about, taking everybody for a ride.
We got up, alarm went off at 2:45 this morning, cup of coffee, we're reading a book. We started on, let's see right here, Walk Down Wall Street. Even though I'm not in the market per se heavily like a lot of people are, I do buy one stock. It's always good to educate yourself, and at some point I plan on getting out of real estate and having more of a passive income, not having to lift a finger, manage people, get materials, pound nails, all that kind of stuff. So first thing this morning though is yesterday, Carla was at a job site, got finished up at 1:36, left there in the afternoon. The tenant next door said, hey, I left at 2 o'clock, came home at like 5:30. Somebody had broken into their house. They also broke into my units and stole some tools and everything. So that really sucks. And hopefully they came back last night, but you know, it is what it is. And great thing is that when I make money, I don't go spend it all. So we got money to replace those tools, but we shall see.
This is one of those days that where anything could go wrong, it will. And it's just a law of averages. I have a lot of great days and I should have one bad one every now and then. So I'm in the store, checkout line, I get a drink, get a beef jerky, and this lady's in front of me, gets all kinds of picks with the lottery, and then about $50 in scratch offs. Now I can respect somebody that says, hey, I'm gonna learn how to count cards and I'm gonna do the blackjack thing. But folks, you've never met anybody that's a professional scratch off lottery winner, because they don't exist, because the odds are not in your favor. Thing about it is that this is how much effort it takes. I want that one, and then you scratch. See how much effort I had to put forth to do that? Very little. And that's a lot like people want to build wealth. They don't want to put forth any effort. And they have that, what I call the lottery mentality. They want to strike it big first time to get it overnight and be done. And the vast majority of people that get rich that way lose it within 5 years. Mike Tyson, one time worth $300 million. He's worth about $3 million today. You know, and if you watch some of his interviews that he's done in the last couple of years, he talks a lot about not being financially prepared, being financially ignorant, and just being totally careless with his money, thinking that it was never going to run out. Guess what, folks? That day will come. That faucet's going to be shut off. You better be prepared.
Yesterday totally sucked. Well, not really. It wasn't all that bad in the grand scheme of things. We've had a break-in at the property. They came, did it in the middle of the day, got a bunch of stuff, and then came back at night. And unfortunately, it was just a situation where we did not have the ability to have the whole job site secure. Should have gone ahead and loaded everything up that was left of value. And we did end up buying a ring system and put in there. Nobody came in last night. Hopefully today we'll get it to the point where it's secured and easy entry is not possible. We'll be going forward with that. You know, it's just it's a blessing to have rental property to get ripped off. That's all it, you know. And then yesterday I had to go pick up the trailer from Mayhem Motorsports where we had some work done on it, and I backed into it and knocked it off the block. So then I take another 10-15 minutes to get it up, you know, to get it on the trailer hitch. So it's just one of those days, you know. But here's the thing is that there's, despite how good of a person you are, how much you go to church, how good of a husband, wife, parent to your kids, whatever it is, how much money, you know, how many people you help, you know, no matter what, okay, there's nothing that says you should not have a bad day, okay? Just because you do good stuff, you go to work, you're contributing to society, does not mean that you are exempt from bad luck, bad swing of things. It just happens. Now, I will say this, okay, that if you act in a certain manner and do certain things and you're consistent with those things, generally speaking, you're going to do better over time. And what do I mean by that is that, you know, if you're kind and nice to your friends, generally speaking, you're going to have more friends with better relationships. If you're always out for yourself, if you're dishonest, if you're mean, complimentary, you know, chances of you having good relationships that you want to be in, slim. It's not going to happen. So there's a way to hedge your bets and have more good days than bad days. And, you know, but again, just because you're successful or doing the next right thing does not mean you're exempt from having a bad day. It'll come. The odds are there.